Off the Formosa coast, the 7th Fleet pipes aboard a VIP, Generalissimo Chiang Kai-Shek. He lands by helicopter on the deck of the supercarrier Midway. It's the first visit by the 72-year-old Chinese nationalist leader since the current Quemoy crisis began 3 months ago. A visit made possible in part by the cooling off of the crisis in the Formosa Strait. Fleet Commander Admiral Herbert Hopwood leads the welcome, a full show of military ceremony for Chiang. The occasion is, technically, 7th Fleet maneuvers. Maneuvers also made possible by the cooling off of the Quemoy crisis. And very timely as a reminder to all concerned that although the mighty force has withdrawn from patrol and convoy duty, it is still a potent force in being, alert and ready to back up free China. A morale booster for our allies. A sobering reminder to our foes. Latest communist threat to West Berlin apparently already on the wane, the city, with bitter memories of the Red Blockade of 10 years ago, prudently begins to stockpile food, fuel, and staple supplies. If the communists again shift their course and attempt another starve-out operation, this outpost of freedom in the heart of communist East Germany will have a backlog of vital commodities. Traffic along the corridors to West Germany continues to flow freely, and heavy trucks ride the autobahns in stepped-up schedules. Hundreds of military transports wait in readiness as Berlin and the free world make plain their determination to stand off any Red threats. The popular temper was shown as 4,000 protested a communist rally during municipal elections. It took the riot squad to hold back a crowd with ideas of its own for the Reds. In Quincy, Massachusetts, thousands of shipyard workers and families greet Queen Frederica of Greece, who arrives to christen the largest oil tanker ever to be built in the United States. The Queen is accompanied by Crown Prince Constantine and her daughter, the ship's namesake. The tanker, with a 155-foot beam, can haul over 27 million liquid gallons. Ducking behind the bow as she breaks the ritual bottle of champagne, the Queen dubs the huge vessel the Princess Sophia. Down the way she slides, a mighty new vessel for the trade lanes of the seas.